Friday, March 25th, 2022. How are you doing there, guys? I am good. As see it, maybe missed again. Unless you work on weekends, which I know some places that do. I know some people work on weekends. I know I do work on weekends, except for my family. But actually, yeah, I guess you can say I do work on weekends, except it's only one day. It's at the end of the day. And but anyway, guys, how are you guys doing? How's it going? Good. It's another day here. I'm so excited. Because reading the title, Peterbilt. Why did you say that? I want to keep in mind, I want you guys to keep in mind this. Arizona is a very good state. Trailer pack. I believe it's this 3-axle Fontaine Magnitude trailer in its pack. It's a very good trailer. It's actually a very good trailer pack and a very good mod by Jazzy Cat. So, but today we're hauling excavator, but we're gonna be nice here. We're gonna say two mini excavators pretty much, because we all know what an excavator is. We know how big they are. That's not an excavator. But we are going from Tucson, Arizona, Caterpillar to Kingman, Arizona, John Deere. Our job income is $21,348. Our cargo mass is 21,980 pounds. So clearly, it's the weight of two mini excavators. trip time is 6 hours and 47 minutes. Trip distance is 392 miles. Top of the map. We're at 5 hours. We already did 5 hours, but here you go. Right here we're at, and boom. It could make it fun, just, you know, go this way, you know, up and around, but I don't want to make the video too long for you guys. So, but the funniest thing is like, I'll hop on the freight market real quick. Here's Tucson. This is all I had available. Now, don't get me wrong. Some of them are okay, but I didn't feel like, you know, like Elko. Grape juice. Or, there's the other one. It was on here, unless it went. Wait, was it this one? It might have been this one. And I was like, meh. You know what I mean? 13-hour trip, and I could probably do that in one day if I really wanted to. But the video is going to be like 45 minutes long. I don't know. But anyway, if you guys don't remember, I did buy a new garage. I bought some new trailers for the company. So we went down from 5. I think we were at 5.2 million. Excuse me, 3.6 million. But anyways, we do have some interesting news. We have a brand new truck from SCS Software. It's another international. It's the International 9900i. There we go. This truck, I do see here and there, especially this configuration, not this one or this one. I very rarely see a day cab or the 51-inch sleeper, mainly the 72-inch sleeper. Good truck. Just wish it had more chassis, engines, and transmissions. You know, but at least that's my transmission I use. For transmissions, it goes from 10-speed all the way up to 18-speeds, 2-10s, 2-13s, and 2-18s. 1-10 has a retarder, 1-13 has a retarder, and 1-18 has a retarder. So they each have, one has a retarder, one does not. So there you go. And for the engines, it's all Cummins IXX15s. It goes from 450 all the way up to 600, which you can definitely pull some oversized loads with this one, with this motor, if you really want to. Now, I know a lot of people do a lot of different configurations, so. Interior, I've actually seen this interior, and this is actually spot on for this truck, so. Especially, I think, yeah, this one. I think the one I saw had this interior, and that was probably the last time I ever saw one of these. So, but pretty cool. Can't really do too much. I'm not going to go through the whole truck, but a lot of you probably have. And it's a pretty nice truck, not going to lie. So now we have this guy. What up? We have the P139 and the W900. And that's the only three that are not aerodynamic. You guys want? So, he has all these other ones, like the Vienna, he's aerodynamic. Actually, this might, he might be. I don't know. But I think it's pretty cool, another truck added to the game, pretty cool. Oh, excuse me, sorry about that. I just want to answer this one quick question because someone asked me this because they saw it. I think it was a T680. I got asked if this is Goodyear's paint scheme on their trucks for NASCAR. I think they run the T680. I know Michelin does. I believe Michelin does. If I'm wrong, I'll check. But I think I'm wrong. But I think Goodyear runs a T680. And I believe this is their scheme for NASCAR. That, you know, the truck that hauls the trailer to the track with all the tires in it. I believe this is how it looks. It's not this look. I think it's this one. So. That's pretty cool. So. Anyway, I just want to point that out there. I did get asked that question the other day. But all right, let's get back on the road. I feel like we spent too much time. I agree. She said it was for you. So no comment. There you go. Anyway, I just want to clarify a few things. Today's video, we really don't have a topic, but we are going to talk about NFL and baseball. A lot of deals, a lot of free agent signing hasn't happened in between the two. NASCAR, I haven't been really able to watch a full race. I've been watching highlights of races. I can say Atlanta was interesting. That's all I'm going to say for right now. I will talk about NASCAR in later videos. But as of right now, I'm going to talk about Major League Baseball and NFL, even though NFL is not playing at the moment. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to talk about transactions. Or not every transaction, every team, but my main ones that I think are really with these teams. Start off with the AFC East, Buffalo Bills. Definitely the two biggest signings for me from them. is. It's Von Miller and I say O.J. Howard. Signings. I say he did. He did this stuff for other defenses. That's about it. Next up is the Miami Dolphins. Really don't see much of the Miami Dolphins except for one. That is they had a very speedy wide receiver. I have to say, he just got past what was it? Believe Weddle? Waddle? That is the AFC East. If I had to rank them, it would probably be Bills, Dolphins, Patriots, Jets. So next up, the Baltimore Ravens and the AFC North. My biggest two is defensive tackle Michael Pierce and safety Marcus Williams. I feel like that is the two biggest. Obviously, they didn't really sign that much. They only signed four players, but I feel like those two are definitely that defense, especially if Marcus Williams is coming back, which I don't know if he's going to be the same. Cincinnati Bengals, I know he spent a lot of money on offensive line. Colt Collins, Alex Kappa, Tech Krause, three very good offensive linemen. Eli Apple signed him. Really, I look at the Bengals, they are great.
South.
not much, in my opinion, the biggest attacks in the world here is trying to rebuild regular models and double players, which is always fine and dandy. So,
thank you.
touring the Red Sox. Don't know about Chris Bryant for the Rockies. That's kind of really. That's about it. Real quickly, the Los Angeles Chargers. J.C. Jackson. Excellent job, 431 miles. 8 hours and 4 minutes. We continue. Check real quick. And that's about it. For me, I think it's Raiders. Chargers, Broncos, Chiefs. And that's all the AFC. That's all I have time for. Thank you all so much for watching. Sorry about the talk too much, I promise. But anyways, guys, thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. See y'all next time.